Then another type of contemplation in the Satipatthana Sutta is to contemplate on the various types of corpses. A corpse is 3 days old. Some of you, I'm quite sure many of you have seen a corpse which is 3 days old, because our Chinese, if somebody passes away, they put in the body in a coffin and they keep it for 3 days or 5 days or 7 days. So with the glass there for you to see the face. Then when you look at the face, you see for the first time, you get a bit horrified. A bit swollen, blue-black. But that is the way our body is going to turn. After some time, we are going to die. And then the body, or our body also will become like that. So there's nothing to be ashamed about, to be horrified about, because our own body is going to turn like that one day. So before it turns like that, we contemplate. And then if it's 5 days old, how you look like? You start to swell, start to smell. And then the maggots and all will start to appear, eating. And then the fluids will start coming out of the nose, the mouth, the ears, etc. And the private parts, etc. And after it swelled up to a certain degree, then you will burst, and then you will collapse. I think some of you have seen a dog dead on the road, or a cow dead on the road, having been knocked by some car. Then you observe it, you pass it every day, and then you observe how the dog or the cow, it becomes bloated up, and then the skin becomes very tight. And then after some time it bursts, and all the maggots, you can see. So our body also will become like that. And then after some time, the flesh will start becoming less and less as the maggots eat it. You can still see some blood after some time. Maybe the very little flesh is left, and then the blood also will dry up. And after a while, you see it as a skeleton, only bones. And after a long time, even the bones will start deteriorating. After some time, you see the head here, the leg there, the hand, different place, all over the place, and after some time, they will turn into dust. So when we contemplate that way, then it helps us to cut off the conceit, I am, I exist. Last time when I was in Thailand, I was staying in a monastery where they had a place for cremation, and it was purposely built so that the monks could witness the cremation. They had these bricks and all that laid with a place for putting a lot of wood. And then they put the corpse on top of that pile of wood, you know. Then the monks would go and see before they light. And they observe the corpse, and then they pour some petrol, etc. And then they light a fire, and then there's a big flame. And it will burn for a few hours. After several hours, you go back and look. That old lady that you saw suddenly disappeared into nothing, into bones, into fragments, into powder. Then you realize that person that you saw so solid, so real before you, suddenly disappeared into nothing. Then you realize how impermanent the body is. That actually, it is just a temporary thing. So the Buddha said, just like a car. Originally, there is no car. Then they assemble all the parts, put the window, the glass, the tires, everything, and then you call it a car. Or in the Buddha's time, it was a carriage, chariot. Then later, after the car gets broken down, after 20, 30 years, it's thrown into some rubbish heap, then the whole thing starts to deteriorate. The tire will go one place, the windscreen will be broken, all the parts all over the place. Then where's the car? There's no car. It's just a temporary condition. So from there, if we contemplate in this way, it helps us to see that there is no permanent abiding entity in anything in the world.